Tonight, 7.2 million Olympic-sized swimming pools full of water. That is how much ice melted in Greenland in just 3 days this week during the unprecedented global heat wave. It's enough to cover the entire state of West Virginia with a foot of water. René Marsh is out front in Greenland.
Off the coast of northwest Greenland, the water is perfectly still, but puddling on icebergs indicate a transformation is underway. That's the sound of rapid melting, triggered by a few days of unusually warm temperatures. During CNN's first 3 days in northern Greenland, the temperature topped out nearly 10 degrees higher than normal.
It's days like today, warm enough to wear short sleeves, near 60 degrees in Greenland. It's a high melt day when it's this unusually warm, and it's also deeply concerning for scientists.
It definitely worries me. We are at 67 latitude here on top of the world in North Pole. And we could just yesterday, especially not today, but yesterday we could wander around in our t-shirts. That was not really expected.
It's basically at the melting point today. As you can see, now I can make snowballs.
At a research site in northeast Greenland, near melt conditions at an elevation of nearly 9,000 feet made what's usually a frozen landing strip inoperable.
They have a problem when it's this soft as the surface is now.
Climate scientist Aslak Grinstead tweeting, mini heat wave, -1.6 degrees Celsius in the middle of the Greenland ice sheet. Our planned planes are postponed because our skiway is not that good when it is this warm. Unable to fly out, the scientists pass the time playing volleyball in shorts atop the ice sheet. Pre-global warming, Grinstead says temperatures near 32 degrees Fahrenheit at this altitude were unheard of. The National Snow and Ice Data Center tells CNN from July 15th through 17th alone, a melt surge in northern Greenland caused ice sheet runoff of about 6 billion tons of water per day. That's about the volume of 2.4 million Olympic-sized pools. Put another way, enough water to flood the entire state of West Virginia with 1 foot of water in 3 days.
The amount of melt from the ice was very surprising because it was a very warm day. You could even hear the ice was just melting in front of our eyes.
Research scientists tell CNN this extent of melt in North Greenland this past week is quite unusual and will contribute to global sea level rise, which impacts coastal communities half a world away.
So, Renee, the visuals here are incredible. When you talk about 6 billion tons of water melted every day over those 3 days this week, it is really impossible to sort of comprehend the staggering size of that. The question is there more to come, or is that the worst?
Well, you know, this is peak melt season, and the answer is yes, there is more to come. The National Snow and Ice Data Center telling CNN that they're expecting another major melt event later on this week, and they actually expect that one to extend to much more of the ice sheet. And Aaron, you know, we've seen it in Europe, many parts of the U.S. there, and even here in Greenland, these heat waves. And we expect to see a lot more of those as the global climate continues to rise. Aaron?